So welcome to this channel IBMI classes. Today we will going to discuss about BIFs used with pointers. So we have created a simple demo example here to show you how we can use the BIFs percentile allocate, deallocate, reallocate with of pointers within our programs. So let's start. We're creating this example here. So you can see that we have taken one character variable of length this 32767A, which is based on PTR1, and we have taken another pointer variable PTR2 here. So what we have done that here, firstly we have allocated 10 bytes of memory to this PTR1 variable by using percentile allocate function. So here we can give the bytes, number of bytes we want to allocate to this pointer variable within this percentile allocate, then number of bytes. So it will allocate that number of bytes here. Then we have assigned the value of that same number of bytes into that variable by using percentile substring, then field 1, then 1 to 10, and we have displayed that here by using display functions. Now again we have reallocate the same pointer variable with 15 bytes of memory, then assign this 15 character length value to the same field 1 value using the percentile substring function. Now we have displayed the same thing here. Now we have deallocated this pointer 1 variable, means we have freed the allocation, that freed that address, and now we can use that address anywhere with other variables or within the activation group or within the job. So we have assigned the address of this field 1 now, which is based on this PTR1 variable. We can see here to PTR2 variable, and then what we have done that here, that we have assigned PTR1 to star null, that we have removed that address from here, marking it as unreferenced now. And this is the end of the program. So this is the very basic program which tells us that how we can use percentile allocate BIF with the pointers, percentile reallocate BIF, and then deallocate BIF here. So let's try to compile this program and see how it works. So we are compiling this in Qtemp library right now for demo purpose. So we'll set the debug as a source so that we can debug this. Now we'll debug this program. We call this program. You can see that earlier this contains null address, nothing is there in point one variable after the allocation of 10 bytes. So I've got the address now. So we can assign the value to this. So we can see the value of PTR1, the address PTR1. So it holds this value. This is displayed now. Now we have reallocated this memory, this bytes of memory to PTR1. Now we can see that. Now we can see that what value it holds. So this one. Now we have deallocated that pointer 1, firstly displayed, and deallocated that pointer 1 variable. So the now the memory is free. So we can allocate this the address of this PTR1, that field 1, which is based on this PTR1, to any other variable. So we have assigned the value to PTR2. So now PTR2 also for the same address, the value which is the PTR. Now see, source this address. Now it will not hold any address and we cannot see any value because this does not hold any address. Now so this is giving a pointer not set for location again because we have done this, executed this line ptr1 is equal star null. Now the program ends. So this is the basic example for the BIFs using pointers. You can see the same job log that we displayed these two values. We can directly call it as well without any debug. Sorry, end debug this. Now we'll call this. So firstly displayed this one and then this one and then it's. So this is the basic example that we have created today for you guys. So we have seen that how we can use these BIFs, percentile allocate, percentile d, reallocate, deallocate BIF with pointers in our programs. So today this is all for today's video. So we'll come with some other examples that how we can use pointers with some in some other cases. So we'll try to create those cases as well and then we'll show them in our next video. Till the time, goodbye, take care and have sweet dreams. Good night.